Welcome back to another vlog from my pert little film review channel. And I've got an email here from YouTube Chief Executive Officer Neil Moen, who says, "Dear Pete, congrats on smashing through the psychologically important 5,000 subscriber barrier. You should by now have received the complimentary bottle of Irish whiskey. Yep. But you're still going to have to do better than those subscriber numbers if you want to monetize content and get your grubby paws on that sweet, sweet Bet365 ad revenue. Thanks, Neil." There's not a lot of roistering going on in the cinema right now, but here's a film which amusingly roisters its heart out. The Three Musketeers, D'Artagnan. Despite some contemporary touches and inventions, it's a distinctly old-fashioned entertainment, and entertainment is never easy. A new version, in two parts, of Alexandre Dumas' 1844 classic. This is a high-gloss French costume movie, which will have devotees of the Netflix talent agency sitcom Call My Agent wondering which of that show's characters are representing which star. It appears to split its two feature-length episodes in roughly the place that Richard Lester and screenwriter George MacDonald Fraser divided their Three and Four Musketeers in the 70s. Here is part one, and François Civil stars as D'Artagnan, who in 17th century France journeys up from the provinces to Paris, yearning to be one of the elite king's musketeers. Our young swordsman, only that quaint Freudian term will do, romantically meets cute with three grizzled veteran musketeers, Athos, Vincent Cassel, Porthos, Pio Marmaille, and Aramis, Romain Duris, having in his maladroit bumpkin way accidentally jostled or insulted each of them.
D'Artagnan, vous êtes le fils d'Achille?
Oui. Je rêvais comme lui d'enfiler la casaque et de servir mon roi.
Rejoindrai les cadets. Et un jour, peut-être, serai mousquetaire.
Excusez-moi.
Quoi, c'est tout?
Vous voulez donc que je déclare la guerre aux protestants?
Et à l'Angleterre.
Ce serait intelligent que d'avoir peur.
Votre éminence.
Il est dit.
Buckingham et la reine vont enfin pouvoir se retrouver.
La reine préfère le déshonneur à la guerre. Elle aura le déshonneur.
Their impetuous 3-1 duel is interrupted by the swaggering soldiery loyal to the sinister intriguer Cardinal Richelieu, Eric Roof. Our four amigos are united by their detestation of these creepy bullies, and soon D'Artagnan and the gang are drawn into Richelieu's plan to entrap the Queen, Vicky Creeps, into a fake treason plot with her English admirer, the Duke of Buckingham, Jacob Fortune Lloyd, so that Richelieu has a pretext to force the King, a glowering Louis Garrel, to attack French Protestants. This movie also imagines a subplot to frame Athos on a phony murder charge, and it all hinges on the Cardinal's elegant hitwoman, the Milady, in which role Eva Green does a lot of hilarious, long-stemmed pipe smoking. This film goes galloping along, and there's some excellent stunt work. This film reminded me what a sucker I am for somebody jumping onto a horse in a single leap and riding away. There's also an old-school tavern scene, though this film, directed by Martin Bourboulon, steers it away from the trad heterosexist banter. That's to be expected, although purists will regret the lack of barnyard animals for the fight scenes. Flapping, squawking ducks and chickens scurrying out of the way of the duelist. It doesn't happen, never mind. It's a lavishly produced and very enjoyable innocent pleasure. Okay, that's it. Please give this vlog a like and a share on your influential social media platforms. And very importantly, subscribe and leave a comment after you've done so, giving your wholehearted and unreserved support to what I'm doing here. And also, please, please, oh please, buy my book, The Films That Made Me, an edited selection of my essays and reviews for The Guardian. That's it. See you next time.